Your Steve Jones Show podcast is loading now. The Steve Jones Show podcast is sponsored by Sunbury Motors, North 4th Street in Sunbury, and Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. Sports talk where your voice counts. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motors Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Good afternoon, everybody. It is the Steve Jones Show, back in action from the long holiday weekend here on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Matt Catrillo here with you. Steve will soon be there from the Sunbury Motors Studio. Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. And online at sunburymotors.com. Ford, Lincoln, Kia, Hyundai, all new pre-owned inventory. All at Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com. Big news out of Happy Valley just about an hour or so ago. Penn State, including Beaver Stadium, returning to full capacity this fall. Everybody wanted to hear that, and here we are. We've got it. Full capacity returning to Beaver Stadium and all athletic venues this fall, based on the June 1st governor's updated guidance being lifted of all COVID mitigation orders that happened yesterday, and of course the masking in Pennsylvania, as we talked about Friday, is going to be lifted by June 28th or sooner if Pennsylvania 18 and older can get to 70% fully vaccinated. So that is certainly welcome news. So games like the Auburn game, of course, the Michigan game, or really any game for that matter, homecoming against Illinois, it's going to be back to full capacity, and I can't wait. I'm sure everybody else around here can't wait for that. Football season ticket holders will be notified via email beginning next Tuesday that your 2021 football season ticket and non-refundable seat contribution invoices are available via the account manager. And in alignment with the current CDC and university guidance, unvaccinated fans will be required to wear masks inside university buildings at all times after June 28th. And with a return to full capacity in Beaver Stadium, tailgating is back, the team arrival and traffic patterns will all be back as well, and Penn State is also converting to fully mobile ticketing for all fans and sports to allow for improved ticket delivery and management, as well as fewer physical contact points. And there's info at gopsusports.com/mobile tickets. We have this info too on the Steve Jones Show Facebook page, Twitter page, and also at stevejonesshow.com with all those links there and all that info there on season tickets and whatnot. So that is certainly welcome news to have everybody fully back for football season in all sports, but for football, men's basketball, and the like. I love it. I'm glad that we've come to this conclusion. We knew it was coming. Steve had been kind of hinting that there were some meetings in the works to decide this, and it was probably going to need to be decided soon when we were talking about this last week, based on trying, now that the schedule is coming out, we found out a couple of kickoffs for a couple of games late last week, so we knew that this was a matter of time before this would get announced. And so there you have it, full capacity, and we can't wait. Can't wait to see everybody back at Beaver Stadium this fall, Bryce Jordan Center, and the like. So Steve will have, I'm sure, more on that when he joins us. Now, a lot to recap from over the weekend. And I am going to start with the Sixers, because now this is a growing, there's two growing problems to me now that the NBA has to address. First and foremost is the fans. Where now you've had five separate notable incidents with fans interfering with the games. The latest one, last night when the fan ran onto the court at Capital One Arena, home of the Wizards, during the Wizards-Sixers Game 4 last night. And kudos to that officer. That was a perfect form tackle to get that idiot down. But I think now that this has happened a number of times, they had the popcorn thing, the water bottle with at Kyrie Irving in Boston at the end of the Nets-Celtics Game 3 that occurred actually on Saturday night, the night before, or Sunday night, excuse me, the night before. And you had the thing with John Moran, with his family, those racial slurs that were mentioned, of course, the popcorn thing with that in Philly with Russell Westbrook. I think it's time now where maybe the NBA has to look at, do they get rid of the close court seating, Steve? But we'll get to that later. First, back to the good news. Beaver Stadium, 107K back. Woohoo!
I think all of us expected that.
Yeah, I did too, based on how we were going. But still nice to finally hear it. Official.
But to finally hear it was really important. Look, it's for the student athletes. It's something that, you know, look, they thrive in front of fans. Coaches want it because home court, home field, home ice means everything. You know, they love it, and for the fans, phenomenal. Now, see, but there's layers within here that have to be examined quickly to answer questions that people were concerned about. One of them is, oh, by the way, back to full activities. That means tailgating. Yes. That means team arrival. Yes. You know, that means everything that you saw in 2019 is what you're going to get now at a Penn State event. That's what, you know, when you look at the release, you know, I expected the 107. I was just waiting to see how everything was going to turn out with other stuff. So football season ticket holders are going to be notified beginning Tuesday, June 8th, a week from today, that your 2021 football season ticket and non-refundable seat contribution invoices are available via account manager. The non-refundable seat contribution, that's what supports Penn State student athletes, the 800. Through the Levi Lamb Fund. And then details of the Nittany Lion Club single game ticket presale, public single game, and student ticket sales will be released in the coming weeks. Now, with the return to full capacity in Beaver Stadium this fall, there will also be a return to our traditional pregame festivities, including tailgating, team arrival, and yes, the traffic patterns. Penn State's also going to fully convert to mobile ticketing for all fans and all sports to allow improved ticket delivery and management, as well as fewer physical contact points. Fans will be provided with a variety of resources regarding mobile ticketing this summer to ease the transition. And there is, by the way, a mobile ticketing guide at gopsusports.com/mobile-tickets. I will admit, okay, let's take the mobile ticketing part. I'm going to talk about that for a moment. And the reason I want to bring that up is this. Okay, here's the positive, and for some people it'll be a negative. I never thought, ever, that I would use my phone to get into events. I never did. Then last season, I'd have to sit there on my phone. I'd have to fill out the survey on my phone. Once I passed the test, then I'd go through, take a picture of the Q code, boom, and my name came up with my Q code. And that was it, using my phone. Now, I never thought in a million years that is how I would go about business, getting into business. Never. But it was quick, efficient, and was tremendous. Now, the negative part is this. There are some people that like to keep their ticket as a remembrance of the day. some people will put up on the wall. You know, a memorable game they went to, they got a picture and the ticket. Now, I don't know if there's any way to recreate that. Or if everybody's just using a Q code, I don't know. But I'll give you the example. I guess, Matt, you have not been here to the Sunbury Motor Studio, right?
No, not yet. I need to change that, but not yet.
Yeah, you haven't been here. Suit's been here, and then we had the place fumigated. But sorry, that's a different story. Oh, by the way, Elio Castroneves won the Indy 500. Okay, we're done with that. All right, okay, so. Well, I'll give you an example. I have here, now these are press passes. So obviously it's a press pass. I'm looking at the wall here in the studio. Press pass, Cotton Bowl, picture of Jack and me at the Cotton Bowl. I've got a picture up of, in here, framed. Press pass, Madison Square Garden, Penn State, St. John's, picture below it. Press pass, Rose Bowl, picture from Rose Bowl, broadcast booth below it. The press pass of the Rose Bowl. And then I've got the Palestra and a picture courtside of the Palestra below the pass. Because I did a game at Madison Square Garden, I did a game at the Rose Bowl, I did a game at the Palestra, all in a span of 2.5 weeks. It's a pretty good run. But I've got that up there. So that physical remembrance of it, yeah, I've got it. You know, that's the press pass that goes with it. You know, doing it mobily, I mean, I don't have it, you know, this past season, I don't know if I got any physical passes this season. Maybe on the road I did. I guess on the road I did. At home, no, because everything was done with the Q code. But you know what? Hey, if it makes it easier and makes everybody more comfortable, great. You know what? Great. You know, it's 2021. It's the easiest way to go. The only thing I'm wondering is, you know, is there any way to recreate that on your phone? You know what I mean? I'm just wondering, because I don't know. Don't look at me. I'd be the last person to ask, although I'm a little bit better with technology than I think we let on. I think Matt can attest to that.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Sold yourself short a little bit.
But you have to be in tune with it. Years ago, and we're talking about Penn State going back to 100% capacity here and everything, but mobile ticketing is part of this. Years ago, I interviewed a guy who wrote a book entitled Being Digital. I'm not going to get into the name because, to be honest with you, he was so rude to the crew. To this day, no offense. I think about the guy and I get disgusted because you just don't treat people that way. All right. But in the interview, and it was a TV interview I did for a TV show entitled 15 Minutes. And in the interview, I said, how can people who are older, how can adults get themselves acclimated to a digital world? And he gave really a phenomenal answer. He said, have kids. He says, they'll teach the adults because they're so in tune with technology. But in order to do what we do, we have to be in tune with technology now. I will kid about, I'm a dinosaur. And Matt, I think Matt knows as well as anybody when it comes to technology. I have no problem. I hang in there pretty well with it.
You do, yes.
I use it pretty much to my advantage, which includes everything from stats and everything like that as to what we do. Is Kyle in today?
No, he's taking some time off because he's going to be a married man very soon.
I know he is. You know,
so he won't be back with us till middle of the month, probably.
He's a great guy.
He is, yeah.
Great guy. So happy for him. All right. We'll take a break. Today's show is brought to you by Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury. Look, you want to get stuff done, go to purdyinsurance.com. I mean, they take care of so many. It's in more than just insurance. They take care of so many different areas that can help out anybody. It's Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. Here on News Radio 1070 WKOK. So back to full capacity at every venue. That is the story. And you'll get more information beginning a week from today from Penn State about that on Tuesday, June 8th. And while I think the way everything was trending, it was something that was expected. The timing coincides with the governor's announcement. It also coincides with the virtual coaches caravan with James Franklin. This is the night he is participating in the virtual coaches caravan, so it all coincides with that. And so the timing couldn't have worked out any better. And I think it's really important that on June the 1st, when you are sitting there four days away from your opener, your home opener with Ball State, I mean, that is important, where it gives everybody that time now to begin your planning as to what to do. Because that home opener is 104 days away with Ball State. Obviously, the season opener is 97 days away, but hey. Under the category, here we go. I was at Medlar Field, Lebronto Park, broadcasting baseball yesterday. I was over 3,000 fans at the game. You want to know how good that felt?
Beautiful.
You just sense that people are now not as tense. I think that's a big part of it. Now, obviously, the corner office is that's never going to change. All right, that is the master of absolute tension at all times. I can't believe it. I got to carry everything. My shoulders broad. That's your guy. The master.
Taking your calls at 800-795-9565. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
It's amazing how Bill Cowher quoted the suit in our staff meeting. Cowher, in his book on Spygate, "It's only cheating if you get caught." Those are the exact words the suit used in today's staff meeting. It's from the Elio Castroneves book. No, I'm just kidding. I almost fell over when he said it. Now you're reading Cowher's book. Hey, look, it's only cheating if you get caught. Like, wow, what a great philosophy.
S-U-I-T, that spells suit.
It's our guy getting it done. Of course, Jerome Bettis was also quoted in there saying, yeah, he's kind of bummed about Spygate and the whole thing. My whole thing's always been, if you average more than 3.9 yards a carry, it wouldn't have been an issue. But that's another story. Today's show brought to you by our good friends at Purdy Insurance. Market Street in Sunbury, go to purdyinsurance.com. That's what you picked for the play-by-play call of the day. I just saw the message on the board. Really? You are such a suck-up. Oh, my goodness gracious.
Yeah, it was a good ending, and it's history, so I decided to, all right, I'll throw you a bone.
Okay, so after being begged, you've got to get Lee Diffie on, and you're like, yeah, okay, whatever. This is your way of getting him on?
We'll go with that, yeah. It's easier.
All right.
Call it cutting corners, but whatever.
Well, it's what we specialize in. This is what we do. All right. A couple things here. Of course, today's show brought by Purdy Insurance, Market Street, and somebody go to purdyinsurance.com. Also, don't forget about the Purdy Memorial Golf Tournament, Wednesday, August 4th, Susquehanna Valley Country Club, to benefit the Greater Susquehanna Valley YMCA. We're going to do the show there that day. And as far as I'm concerned, let's have ourselves a little blowout party. How about that?
I'm more than ready.
Now let's get to this one. If you want to call in about Beaver Stadium capacity, you want to call in about tailgating, whatever it may be, just give us a call. Okay? 800-795-9565. 800-795-9565. Major League Baseball is going to court. You want to know why? The All-Star Game. They're being sued by a group representing small businesses in the Atlanta, Georgia area. The Job Creators Network, which does feature Home Depot co-founder Bernie Marcus as a founding member, claims that Major League Baseball violated civil rights law with the move. Specifically, the complaint argues that the league purposely and maliciously decided on punishing small business owners when it moved the game out of Truist Park in Atlanta instead of appealing to lawmakers. The group is asking for $100 million in damages for businesses and $1 billion in punitive damages. The move itself, of course, as we all know, happened in April, early in April, when the league decided that in response to a voting rights law that the state had passed was not in line with what the league's values happen to be. This caused Major League Baseball to move the game out of the Braves' home ballpark to Denver. Now, the irony is, I just talked to somebody over the weekend from Colorado. And, you know, you're going to see comparisons, by the way, which I am not going to get into on the show, about the voting rights law in Colorado versus Georgia. That's for Mark and those guys to go over in the morning. Let them talk about that. That's not what the purpose of what I'm going to talk about here. We know things here in Pennsylvania are loosening up, as evidenced by the announcement today that Penn State Athletics is going 100% across the board. Okay? But I guess in Colorado, mandates are still pretty strict. All right? And according to what they told me, they're going to loosen up the mandate for the All-Star game and then go back to the mandate. I said, really?
Certainly doesn't make sense.
I'm just telling you what they told me because they live there, so I'm not, you know.
Wow.
I'm not going to sit here and pretend I'm an expert on Colorado mandates. But they're going to loosen things up for the All-Star game. But then, that's it. okay. I said, explain that? Explain that to me one more time. Again, I'm not going to pretend I'm an expert on it. I'm not. But they live there, so I was like, wow. It's like when Kevin comes on and tells us what's going on in Connecticut. How about that? It's the equivalent of that. See, Matt, I can relate the show to everybody.
That's right.
No. Now, I don't know what the situation is in Colorado. I don't. But they're the ones with the All-Star game. Okay. But now they're being sued. Now, I expected a suit. I don't know about you. I expected there'd be a lawsuit.
It's not surprising, yeah.
Well, you're a business trying to come out of a pandemic. So let's just take it from the business point of view. Again, I don't want to get into the law. It's nothing to do with that. All right? What I'm about to talk about has nothing to do with that. You're trying to recover from this thing, right? You see this as an opportunity. Now, let's take a Penn State. You don't think today's announcement of 100% capacity at all venues didn't put a little jump into the step of business owners in downtown State College? Of course it did. Well, coming out of a pandemic, there are a lot of business owners that were counting on that All-Star game to bring in a little jump. For their businesses. And they're looking around saying, what happened here? How'd this happen? And that's why they're sitting back saying, you got to be kidding me. That's why they're suing. Because they've been counting on it. April's a little late in the game to be told you're out. Especially when you didn't expect it. It's not like Major League Baseball warned everybody, hey, if this passes, we're doing this. They never did that, did they, Matt? I don't recall them ever saying that.
No.
It just kind of came out of nowhere. Like, really? And it's probably what they're suing about. Now, whether it goes anywhere, I don't know. It's one thing about, there's certain sports, Major League Baseball is one, where being attorneys on retainer, boy, does it pay big, big dividends. The NCAA is the other one. Wow. Wow. So, that is the story on the suit going on. The lawsuit. I don't mean the suit. We've mentioned the suit so often, sometimes we use the term in a sentence where it has nothing to do with him. You have to rephrase. But, wow. You probably, of course, had a wild weekend. Knowing you.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Glad you admitted it. By the way, TNT, including Marv Albert, goes back to in arenas now. So there you go. Every TNT broadcast will be back to normal with announcers in arenas. Now, I'm waiting to see when ESPN starts to do this with Major League Baseball. You know, Tim Kirkson said he was hoping by the 4th of July. Now, I don't know if Fox Sports Like they've got a game, I think, tomorrow. No, tonight. White Sox and Cleveland on FS1 with Adam Amin and A.J. Pruszynski. I wonder, are they studio-based or are they on-site now?
You know what? I haven't been able to tell with them yet. But I do know NHL and NBC has been back.
Oh, yeah. I know. They're in arenas and it shows. You can tell.
Yeah. But I don't know about Fox.
Yeah, I'll tell you, you want to know what really showed was the Corey Kluber no-hitter. Corey Kluber no-hitter took place in Texas. And none of the Yankees individuals were there. And man, you listen to the calls of it, you can tell. You just miss so much not having the presence of the person there. You just do. You know, the feeling, the vibe in the park or the arena or anything like that. You see things, for example, that aren't on camera. You know, so much.
I think what happened with that, I just noticed because Michael Kay put a behind-the-scenes view, like his call from the booth, and even hearing John Sterling's radio call. I think what happened was whoever was at second bobbled the ball initially, so I think that made both John Sterling and Michael Kay hesitate a little bit before the final out was made. I think if it was a cleaner-made play, then you probably wouldn't have noticed. But that little...
Yeah. But again, if you're there, you can see the runner and
right,
you realize
exactly.
He's got him.
Yeah.
Okay? That's all part of being there. You look over and you can just say, quick glance, oh, he's got him. You know? Instead of the guesswork. And that's what they were doing. They were doing guesswork. Not easy to do it that way. Not easy at all. All right. Great to have you with us today. The Sixers lost an MRI for Joel Embiid. Suddenly panic ensues in the Cotrillo household.
From what I'm seeing, I think we're okay, but the NBA's got two major problems they now need to talk about here and they need to address.
Does one include getting the Sixers out of the playoffs to increase ratings?
No.
Oh, just thought I'd bring that up. You talking about fans?
The fan thing is one, and the absolutely atrocious officiating that has now affected two of these games in this series. Game one was awful, but the Sixers were able to prevail and pull away. Last night, Ben Simmons has did his free throws. There's no questions asked about that. That's a separate topic with him. But that officiating last night was egregious. Absolutely egregious.
So you're saying the only way you lose is because of bad officiating. The other team can't outplay
No,
you?
They lost last night because Ben Simmons didn't hit his free throws.
Okay.
And because Joel Embiid didn't play. Was out. Those are the two main reasons why they lost. But the third reason, the officials were very bad, and it solely affected the Sixers.
My
Wizards
goodness,
got a lot of calls last night.
Man, I feel like I'm at a state college quarterback club thing. All right, we'll come back with more in a moment. Great to have you. Like, you sit there going, like, eight questions are about the officiating. It's like, oh, for God's sake.
Just let him play. I'm not asking for much. Just let it play and keep it both sides. They didn't do that last night. Not even close.
My goodness, you 3 days and there's so much pent-up anger.
I think the Sixers, assuming Joel Embiid looks like he's going to play tomorrow, but either way, I think the Sixers win tomorrow night. I do. Well, those are two things the NBA's got to deal with now, is the officiating and the fans.
A lot of pent-up anger here. Wow. Does Dick Bavetta know you feel this way?
I'm sure he does. and every other Sixer fan.
Oh,
it was practically trending on Twitter last night.
Oh, okay. As you know, I often check Twitter out to see what's trending.
Always.
Wow. Okay. You can't believe it's happening on Twitter.
On that note.
I don't care. See, that's what you got to understand. I don't care. What the heck? I'll sit there and really worry too much about it. Can't believe it. Oh, no.
What?
It's awful. What? Because what some guy in Duluth, Minnesota thinks about it, I don't care. It's like, play on. You lost the game because you didn't hit free throws. You didn't lose the game because the officials are in the bag for Washington. You can't accept that, can you?
No, I've accepted that. That's a different, like I said, that's a different topic, but the officiating, I think, needs to be addressed. But Ben Simmons has to hit his free throws. So there's no questions asked there.
Bill Cowher, it's only cheating if you get caught. All right. Back with more in a moment, brought to you by Purdy Insurance here on News Radio 1070 WKOK. When it comes to car buying, there's the other guy's way, and then there's the SMC way. The other guys force you into a vehicle you really don't want. The Sunbury Motors way lets you take the time you need to browse, ask questions, and take the test drive and think on it. For over 100 years, the Mertz family and all their employees have made your experience the most pleasant one you'll ever have. The other guys won't offer you the best price for your trade, no matter how much they say they will. The SMC way is their promise to provide you with the most money the market shows your vehicle is worth. The SMC way is to offer you all applicable factory rebates on new vehicles and generous discounts. Looking for a pre-owned vehicle? The SMC way checks each vehicle in a 200-mile radius to determine the lowest price, then beat it. It's the lowest price promise, just part of the SMC way. The choice is up to you. The other guy's way or the SMC way. The SMC way wins every time. Sunbury Motors Company in the North 4th Street Auto Plaza, Sunbury, and at sunburymotors.com. Selling more cars and satisfying more customers for over 100 years.
As Curry misses a three, another rebound for Hachimura.
Right now, Philly is getting.
They blew the whistle. Oh, my gosh. Security guard.
That was a great tackle, too.
Yeah. Wrapped him up down low.
And you see, he didn't want no parts of it. He didn't want no parts of that, too. Look, now you got him in the full Nelson.
You know, I didn't see what happened. I thought it was somebody trying to mop up an area of the floor. And then all of a sudden, I see a guy get wrapped up and tackled. Ron Rivera is on the phone trying to see if he can get that security guy signed.
I tell you what, you see Brad laughing. Man, I don't know what's going on with these fans night in, night out. Something is happening in every arena. What's going on?
Man, I didn't realize the suit was out of town. Oh. I didn't know he went to Washington. All right. Hey, by the way, just a quick note. Matt Gelb, covering the Phillies, tweeted this out today. It wasn't the prettiest first month for the Phillies farm system, but one of the better performances came from Bryson Stott. He was promoted today to Double-A Redding. Stott, 23, led all High A East with a .453 on-base percentage. It was a little surprising that he did not begin the season at Double-A, but he's there now. Of course, we've had Bryson on the show before. Great guy to talk to. I'll tell you, watching him play 2 years ago, I thought he was a phenomenal prospect. Phenomenal prospect. So, Phillies fans, you do have some help on the farm, all right? And that is a name to watch. I'd watch that more than Mickey Moniak.